Hello and welcome to Beekeeping UK, to a video where I'm not wearing my bee suit and I'm not in the apiary. But instead we're here in the workshop and we've had a really busy couple of weeks here. We've been adding supers to the oilseed rape bees and recently we've taken all of the honey off the oilseed rape. So that all needs to be extracted. Because if you have any experience with oilseed rape, you will know that it sets extremely fast and you're not getting out of your frames if it crystallizes in your frames, and you're gonna have to just whack it in an happy melter. So what I'm gonna do in this video is I'm gonna take you down to the extraction facility, which was refurbished last year. I'll be showing you the extractor, how we extract, how we uncap, and how the whole process works here at the bee farm. Okay, here we go. So, hopefully I won't be attacked by any bees that are already in here. There seems to be quite a few. We bought some supers in this morning. We've got huge clumps of bees. We tried to get most of them out. We've been using porter bee escapes, but a couple don't go out, and then we've got this. But let's start off with the extractor. So this is a stainless steel extractor from Thomas Apiculture. So we'll run through how it all works and how it does here at the apiary. Okay, so the first thing you're probably gonna want to look at is the extractor. This is the extractor. Usually when you have an extractor or somebody who has let's say 50 to 500 hives, you'll have a radial extractor, which is a round thing that usually takes 20 frames. This is slightly different. This is a Thomas Apiculture extractor. It is 20 frame, but it's built into this big base, which we'll run through. This is currently set up for national frames, but obviously it can take any other frame by moving these pieces here. But it's a 20 frame electric extractor where all the honey will run out here once it's been flicked onto the side and down, and then it'll move its way out into the bucket. So what's great about this extractor is that it has the uncapping area built in. Most of the time, people on this semi-commercial basis will have an uncapping bay, which will go straight into an appy melter. What we have here is a little uncapping bay where you can put your frame on this little spike here. You get your knife or your hot knife. We prefer not to use hot knives, because obviously you're touching it with over 35 degrees. So we just use a normal sharp gourmet knife. And then all the wax will go straight into here that you can see. So all the cappings go straight into the... And then all of the honey which is in the cappings is gonna drip down through these holes here and straight down into the tray. So then it's shaped where the honey will drip down past the honey that's coming off the extractor and straight into the bucket. All of the wax cappings that are left here in the tray can then be transferred into a appy melter, which we have down in the workshop. Right, so now you can see that the frames have been uncapped, and all the leftover wax cappings are in there to drip down. Here is where we put all our frames, ready to be uncapped, and once they've been uncapped they go there. And then they can be loaded into the extractor, which is a 20 frame extractor. So we just pop the lid down there. And then we're just gonna slowly let it run. Thank you. Okay, so we've got all the frames extracted. We just got a last batch to do here, and then we've got to load it all back in the supers, and then they can be put back into storage ready for the summer honey.
So like I said at the start of the video, some bee farmers put their wax straight into an Appy melter. And then we transfer what we've got is the tray, and then the wax is put in a bucket and put into the Appy melter. So the Appy melter we keep here in the workshop. It's a big, nice stainless steel thing. I think this one's about 1,500 quid. But it's a Suenti Appy melter. So if you don't already know what this does, this, you put your wax straight inside into like a tray, which is here, and all the wax is heated then, which you can see, there's a thermostat there, and then you choose your the heat, and that basically melts the wax, and all of the honey that is left in there, it all then goes and melts into like a bottom tray, which you can probably see the line there, it goes down there, and then there's a nice little tap here. So what we do, we put it in one big bucket, and because it's over the 35 degrees limit, which is the temperature of the hive, we don't sell that as the honey, because then it's not raw. What we label it as is baking honey. Our baking honey we put in a tub, and then it's a discounted price, so then people can either put that in their tea or obviously bake with it. So it's a lot cheaper and a bigger quantity, but obviously you don't get all that goodness that you would with raw honey. So if you're looking for nukes at this time of year, because you've just started beekeeping, then we do have some spring nukes for sale. All of our nucleus colonies that were overwintered with a 2018 queen all sold, and they sold within a week. So these bees are now up for pre-order. If you want to message me through Facebook or leave a comment, and I can respond to you and give you the relevant contact details for these bees. Okay, that's it. ...2019 extraction of the spring honey over. That's a wrap on a couple of hectic days that we've had here. Looks like all the honey is totally out. So now we're going to let all the honey that's left in here drain into the bucket, and obviously all of the wax cappings as well. They're dripping down. We'll run down through here and straight into the bucket, where we've got some beautiful Welsh honey on tap. Now we have a couple of supers which all need to be put into the storage facility, and then they will hopefully all be gone and back on the hives after what we call here is a June gap. So there'll be a gap at the start of June until mid-June. For some reason I have a bad feeling that this is going to be quite a long June gap. No reason in particular, other than we've had quite a bit of good weather. Sycamores started to come out around here, and there are things that are starting to come out nice and early, but I do still think that there will be a bit of a gap around, although a lot of bee farmers have been tweeting that there may possibly not be a gap, which would be quite good for us. The good thing about this is that you are just letting all the honey naturally just drip out of the
wax cappings and just go straight down into the bucket, and anything that is left over the wax cappings can just be put straight into an appy melter. And like I was saying about the cooking honey, we have a nice pot here. They are cooking honey buckets, very nice to have, great for putting in your tea. Okay, so that's that for extracting today. Now we've got to run up to the oilseed rape. As it's gone over, there's nothing for them to do now around the area, so we're going to bring them back to their base apiary, where they can spend the rest of their time now. Is going to be the June gap, and then July time, Himalayan water balsam will come out, and then they'll be all over that, and then that's when our main honey crop comes on. Okay, so if you watched the video when we moved the bees down to oilseed rape, you'll be able to see that it's not even one bit as yellow as it was. It really is a dark green now, and more than 80%, 90% of it is green, which is a good indicator of we need to get the hive moved. There's going to be a total relapse of a couple of weeks ago when we put all the bees on the big trailer and took them back to base. Can you hear me, SOS? Help me put my mind to rest. Two times clear, gonna map the Lord. A pound of weed and a bag of blow. Feel your love pulling me up from the underground. I don't need my drugs. We could be more than just part-time lovers. I can feel your touch picking me up from the underground. I don't need my drugs. We could be more than just part-time lovers. We could be more than just part-time lovers. Okay, so as the sun sets behind me, it's finally time to go home. We've got all of the boxes ready for move, which will be tomorrow morning. We've also extracted all of the oilseed rape honey that we took off today, and all of the honey extraction is done now for spring honey. So that's it now for this video. Please go and follow us on Twitter. You'll be able to see what we're up to on a daily basis on there. Also subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already, to see more videos, and also click the bell to find out when I've uploaded. Feel your
from the underground. I don't need my drugs. We could be more than just part-time lovers. I can feel your touch picking me up from the underground.